Royal shock, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry could stand to gain from Queen's royal ban. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's Marmite brand will not suffer from their royal status being stripped, a PR expert has claimed, and could even become more powerful after official links to the monarchy are severed. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are set to officially begin their new royal free roles on April 1 after they have carried out their final engagements in the UK. The Queen, 93, and senior palace officials are believed to have banned the couple from using the term royal in their branding, an order which will spell a huge amount of trouble for the pair as they have trademarked Sussex Royal on a range of items. But Piers Bracker, a deputy managing director at Four Communications, said the loss of the word royal from their brand was not significant in terms of the influence the duo hold. He told The Times, "They don't need to use it. They are very well known and liked in the United States. If I were them, then the sensible thing to do would be to take off that word voluntarily. The spotlight is even further on them. Rather weirdly, they've increased their brand value because of it." Harry, 35, and Meghan, 38, could rake in millions of dollars from commercial deals across the pond as they step away from their platform in the royal family. Their Sussex Royal Foundation is due to be launched stateside in the coming months, although the title has now been called into question. Earlier this week, reports suggested the monarch had banned the use of the term royal for financial gain. A source told the Daily Mail if they aren't carrying out official duties and are now seeking other commercial opportunities, they simply cannot be allowed to market themselves as royals. After returning to the UK later this month to carry out six final engagements, Harry and Meghan will head back to Canada ahead of two important milestones. Little Archie will celebrate his first birthday on May 6 ahead of his parents' second wedding anniversary on May 19. Harry will visit Abbey Road Studios on February 28 to meet singer Jon Bon Jovi and members of a military veterans choir, in one of his last engagements as a senior member of the royal family. He will visit the famous studios in North London where the Beatles recorded 11 of their 13 albums. The father of one will meet the Bon Jovi frontman and the Invictus Games choir, who are recording a single for charity. The choir is made up of veterans and serving personnel from the British military. Proceeds from the sale of the record will go to the foundation that supports the Invictus Games. The song, called Unbroken, was created by Jon Bon Jovi to shine a spotlight on veterans living with post-traumatic stress disorder and honor their service, a palace statement said. The singer's parents both served in the U.S. Marine Corps, while Harry served in the British military before he took on full-time royal duties. In the faked video, which was shared on the Duke's official Instagram page, the musician messages the royal saying, "Hey Harry, how's it going?" The Duke then replies, "Hey. I'm good. Just living on a prayer."